Dneska to bola taká multikultúrna zostava, pretože takmer z každého kontinentu to bolo zastúpenie. Benito tu už predčasom hral, pochádza z Venezuely, žije v New Yorku. Esiet pochádza z Nigérie, ale už sa narodil ako Američan. Alex Sipiagin pochádza z Ruska a žije takisto dlhé roky v New Yorku. Koncertoval s tými najlepšími, takisto ako všetci tí ostatní. No a samozrejme naše zázračné dieťa, dnes už mladý muž, 20-ročný Dávid Hodek, môj dlhoročný spoluhráč, takže dneska to bola kapela mojich snov. To boli všetko naše vlastné kompozície. Teraz sme na šnúre, budeme nahrávať CDčko. Každý z členov kapely prispel svojou časťou alebo svojou teda predstavou o tej hudbe, svojimi kompozíciami. Takže pozajtra to ideme nahrať a veľmi sa na to teším. Akokoľvek je kompozícia napísaná, tak každý ten hudobník, každý dobrý hudobník ju zahrá úplne inak, pretože má tú svoju vlastnú predstavu o tom. Hej. Pre mňa osobne je jazz hlavne teda soul a tam tá improvizácia, to je tá esencia jazzu. Téma je len niečo, čo má muzikanta naviesť na tú cestu, ako akorát solo. Solo je tá sloboda, to je tá pravá esencia jazzová. Takže v tejto zostave som rád, pretože funguje veľmi dobre chémia, fantasticky. Dávid, Benito, Esiet už niekoľko rokov tvoria vynikajúcu rytmickú sekciu, ktorá je akýmsi motorom a takým hnacím srdcom tej kapely, a Alex vynikajúco zapadol do tejto zostavy. A je to veľký profesionál, fantastický človek, skromný. A veľmi dobre sa mi s tým hrá a funguje tá chémia medzi nami.
It's incredible. You know, I met Radovan a couple of years ago, actually in Moscow during some jazz festival, and we immediately click to each other musically, and since that we try to find a time to put some project together, and it's finally we got this our first tour together, and it seems like it works very well. Incredible. I live in United States, you know, but I go to Russia maybe 2 times a year. And from what I see, you know, jazz is growing no matter what politics or anything else. Jazz is completely separate, you know, tree, which is growing constantly. And actually not just in Russia, in every country. And every time I go there, I'm very excited to meet some new young musicians who, you know, constantly appear on jazz festivals and in the scene.
It's all good. You know, I'm happy to be back. I enjoy always playing with Radovan. And, my first time playing with Alex was great. You know, he's a great musician, and we have a great chemistry. It's a good ensemble. You know, we have David Hodek on the drums and Essie. It's special. For this particular ensemble, I was writing in the Latin tradition. Some of the tunes and some other ones were from the jazz tradition, from the straight ahead. So, you know, we are mixing both concepts in the shows.
Základ projektu je môj kvartet a ako býva vo zvyku už v minulosti, rád si pozývam hosti. A vždy si pozývam hosti, s ktorými by som rád spolupracoval a mám predstavu, že to môže fungovať. A jedným z takých hostí je Aaron Goldberg. Môžem povedať, že to bolo možno jedna z najlepších klavírnych spoluprác, ktoré som v histórii našej kapely, ktorá asi funguje 6. rokom, mal. Áno, my sme hrali takú, dá sa povedať, takú výberovku. Veci, čo asi najviac budú sedieť do konceptu s týmto pianistom. Boli to vlastne od úvodnej skladby, ktorá je takou našou hymnou úvodnou. Nahrali sme ju na debutovým album. Má viacero podôb, je zaranžovaná aj do Big Bandu. Premiérovali sme ju v rozhlasovom Big Bande Gustava Broma. Až skladby ako je Ali, čo je titulná skladba z najnovšieho albumu, čo sme nahrali s Bobom Incerom. A skladba Petrology, čo je titulná skladba rovnomenného albumu. A boli tam aj nové skladby, ktoré ešte neboli nahraté. Ako bola napríklad balada pre priateľku Žanetku, Žanet. A skladba Orphar Woods, ktorú som ja nenahral pre seba, ale nahral som ju pre veľmi dobrého priateľa Ludovita Kotlára. Prekvapilo ma napríklad tá vec, že si veľmi užíva hudbu, keď hrá s nami, a páčia sa mu naše kompozície. To ma veľmi teda prekvapilo, že to v ňom vzbudí nejakú pozitívnu emóciu, pretože naozaj tých koncertov a jeho spolupráca, on sám ako skladateľ, alebo keď hral teda v roli sidemana, si určite musel zahrať s veľa dobrými muzikantmi kvalitnú muziku a tú našu naozaj ocenil a je to taký príjemný pocit na duši, že aj takémuto muzikantovi v podstate vyhovujú naše kompozície a vyhovovalo mu aj to, ako hráme. A čo sme veľmi radi, že sme ho nesklamali. Takže bola to dobrá voľba pozvať k nám do Čech a Slovenska.
Yeah, it's been fun. You know, I didn't know any of them before. Actually, they told me that I met them a long time ago here at Brno Jazz Fest, but I had never played with Lukáš or Thomas or Marian before. So, but I, you know, Lukáš sent me an email, invited me, and I checked out some of his recording on the YouTube, and I could tell that he was an excellent musician. And so I just went for it, you know, took a risk and trusted my intuition, and it paid off. I had a really nice couple days playing with these guys. They're all very talented, and it's inspiring to find musicians you've never heard of before that play at such a high level all over the world. The one thing that's very clear about all three of these guys is they have beautiful sounds on their instrument, and they've spent a lot of time studying the African-American tradition, you know, that I come from in my home. So it doesn't feel like I'm playing with guys who grew up on the other side of the world. It kind of feels like I'm playing with guys in New York who happened to be residing in Slovakia. Musically, it felt pretty much at home. Like I the tunes felt like I could have encountered them in Manhattan. So it was not a culture shock at all, no musical culture shock. Jazz is, for me, it's the greatest music because, first of all, the skills that are required to become a great improviser on any instrument are extremely high level. You know, it's kind of like being both a classical composer and a classical, you know, performer at the same time, because you need the musicianship skills to write in the moment, spontaneously compose in the moment masterful pieces of art, but you also need the technical skill to execute night after night. So it's as challenging, you know, as being sort of Glenn Gould and Bach at the same time. That's one way to look at it. And it's also, you know, it's African-American tradition. It comes from soulful, you know, blues music and rhythmic, you know, innovations coming from Africa, syncopation, dance music. Like it's something that stimulates your mind, moves your heart, and gets your booty shaking, gets your feet moving, makes you feel good at the same time. So for me, there's nothing that compares to it. I mean, I'm just amazed at how much Jazz Fest Brno has grown since I was here last time. I think I was here towards the very beginning of it. It could have been this first or second year. Now I see there's so many concerts going on for months. So congratulations to the producers in the city and all the sponsors. And it's just very cool to see jazz festivals growing. And also this jazz festival seems to have real jazz, like a lineup of excellent jazz from all over the world, high quality lineup. Maybe the you know, the programmer being a musician is partly helping there. That's, yeah, credit to him too.
Tomáš Baroš, Maria Šovčík, Lukáš Rozpad.